Hello, Mr. William. So glad to see you here. Can I call you Bill? By the way, who is this pretty lady, if I may ask?
Hello, Mr. Atkins. I'm William's wife, Catherine. I'm a historian myself. I hope you don't mind me coming along.
No, no. In fact, I'm very happy that you came. This is wonderful. Absolutely wonderful.
Well, where do we start our research?
Right here, right now. Bruno, please do the honors.
William, these people are not what we thought they were. They are treasure hunters.
And Bill here is the key to our treasure. The famed Corwin's treasure, to be more specific.
They say he lived here in hiding until his death, and his treasure is buried somewhere in this town.
Enough talk. I have heard about your ability to decipher symbols. I am sure opening the Mayan box will not be a difficult task for you. Until then, dear Kathy remains with us. Good luck, Bill. Well done, Bill. I knew you could do it. These Mayan boxes creep me out. I would never touch them myself. But I don't mind you messing with them, as long as they bring you closer to the treasure. By the way, I have heard Corwin was a regular visitor to the church. You might want to search it for any clues. You won't want your pretty wife hanging on the gallows like that cursed box up there, would you?
Thank you. them.
These guys are crazy! What are we gonna do? You can fly the talisman, but I can't. It's too risky for us to try and get down from here. I have heard them talking about Jackson's hotel. Maybe they are there. Please, just keep on searching for this wretched treasure. Don't worry. I will be okay.
I have heard you met with your wife just moments ago. Why are you so worried? All you need is to find the treasure, Bill. Then you and your wife can get out of this mess. I promise never to bother you again. Legend has it that Corwin had become a drunkard in his final days. He spent many nights here at Jackson's Hotel drinking till he passed out. Then one fine day, he just disappeared. But he was last seen here at Jackson's. Thank you.
I have been keeping an eye on you since you arrived here. I know about you and your wife. I know you need my help, but at the moment, I myself am in need of help. My teeth necklace is missing. It is as precious to me as anything. Until I find it, I cannot waste my time talking to you. Thank you. I am indebted to you. Tell me what you want. Ah, I knew this Atkin was up to no good. This is why I didn't risk talking to him. I live here in the forest to guard the sacred lake. My father assigned this task to me before he died. I do not know what lies in the sacred lake, but he told me never to allow bad men to dive into it. You are a good man. That is why I'm giving you this box that you need. My father gave it to me for safekeeping, just like his father before him. Maybe you can figure out how to use it.
Thank you.
What is happening? What is happening to me?